As of November 6th, 2022, there are 45 volcanoes erupting across 7 continents. This week's stories involves one volcano which is erupting and two which are not. In Indonesia, the erupting Semeru volcano underwent a significant increase in the amount of ground uplift at its summit. Meanwhile, in Italy, the Campi Flegrei volcano finally passed a threshold of how much the ground has been uplifted. This threshold was last reached in 1984 and in part triggered the evacuation of the town of Pozzoli. And, in Ecuador, we have finally confirmed that the Cotopaxi volcano did produce an eruption in late October of this year. Additionally, due to newly measured data, it seems that Cotopaxi now has an increased likelihood of erupting again. For context, the Cotopaxi volcano in north-central Ecuador is the planet's third most consistently explosive volcano out of more than 1,000, which have erupted since the end of the last ice age. In the last 8,000 years, Cotopaxi has produced 7 VEI-5 explosive eruptions which were greater than or equal in size to the 1980 eruption of Mount St. Helens. After Cotopaxi's 2015 to 2016 eruption ended, the volcano did not show any major signs of life. That was until October 21st of 2022. At 7:44 p.m. on that day, seismic stations on the volcano detected a near-continuous volcanic tremor. This activity caused a discernible mainly white plume to rise a kilometer or 3,300 feet above the already 19,393-foot-tall glacier-covered volcano. During this activity, this plume also carried with it a moderate amount of ash which was subsequently deposited around the crater rim and several thousand meters down the volcano's slopes. Although this activity ended at 12:40 a.m. on October 22nd, it for several days remained unclear if an eruption even occurred. Sometimes, a volcano can output ash via significant amounts of gas pressure which break off sides of a volcano's magma conduit. However, in this case, it was revealed that a weak phreatomagmatic eruption truly did occur, which was assigned a preliminary VEI rating of 01. According to the local geological agency, the erupted ash was 22% new material, which, along with gases that had a distinguishably magmatic signature, indicated a magmatic component to the eruption. This means that magma is present within the volcano's magma conduit, which in the coming weeks to months could result in a more prolonged eruption, like witnessed between August of 2015 and January of 2016. Meanwhile, in Italy, the Campi Flegrei volcano, which is often cited by literature as a supervolcano, has passed a worrying threshold. Since record-keeping began at this volcano, sections of ground have been uplifted and have subsided by as much as 100 feet, causing ancient towns to sink below sea level and for ancient shorelines to now be far above the modern Mediterranean Sea. All of this is caused by the movement of magma in the volcano's massive magma chamber, which has produced VEI 6 and 7 eruptions in the last 50,000 years. Since 2011, one such episode of uplift has been occurring due to a very shallow intrusion of magma estimated to be ongoing at a depth of approximately 3 kilometers. This has pushed up the ground underlying the Pozzoli site by 89 centimeters or 35 inches. Well, as of the last week or so, the volcano has now passed a threshold of uplift reached during a similar magmatic uplift period that triggered evacuations in 1984. For a long time, it was believed that if the volcano was uplifted a total of 6 meters beyond a certain point, that it would be fully capable of producing a new eruption. However, unlike during 1984, we no longer believe that passing this threshold is likely to trigger an eruption in the near-term future, as the rate of uplift is much lower than witnessed during that period. Most likely, several more meters and perhaps tens of meters will be needed before an eruption does occur. At the Semeru volcano in Indonesia, the amount of ground deformation is no longer rapidly increasing after a worrying increase earlier this week. While it was being pushed upwards by 2 centimeters a day, it is now being pushed upwards at a mere fraction of this rate. This suggests but does not confirm that the chance of a large eruption being triggered has dramatically decreased for the time being. Here is a quick list of every volcano which is currently erupting. Also, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting but could erupt in the near future. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, if you wish to support this channel, consider becoming a patron on this channel's Patreon page.